So, you know, it's not easy to communicate this stuff. I mean, you just did an amazing job at trying to communicate it graphically.
Well, I've been speaking to engaged Zephyrs all over the world for years now.
That's great. Yeah. And it's okay if you don't get it right away. We didn't either. You know, I'm not proud of a lot of my earlier work. You can look at it on this channel, but I'm not proud of it. You know, a lot of it is humiliating. It's not really expressing Zephyr philosophy. But there's one or two videos where you can see sideways thinking creeping in. And one of them is in the Awareness Walkathon, where I just decided to run sideways.
Mm-hmm.
Why did I do that?
These new forms of awareness, they have these ways of working their way into our being that we can't see.
Yeah.
Often, my hypothesis, and this is, you know, after speaking to many aspiring Zephyr males out there over the years, is that particularly with visual mediums such as yours,
mm-hmm.
we look from the front of our faces like this, right? Which makes it very difficult.
Sideways sure, thinking. That makes sense.
You know what I mean?
And it's weird, actually, you say that, because I was not only running sideways, but in that the person that filmed it was tracking me using a sideways pan. And I mean, I don't want to dwell on my work, because what I want to do right now is listen to a couple of your tracks, because there's one track, well, I'll let you explain it. I mean, basically you were saying there was one track that you really weren't happy with, but then you went back and something happened.
Absolutely. Yes. So this kind of goes back to my island of the mind, that I was telling you about earlier, which is that when I saw this crab in front of me, that really kind of sparked this new way of thinking, I realized that my work as a creator of electronic music, I think through my ears, you see. And so I looked at the crab and I saw its eyes were on the side.
And do you know what as well about crab eyes? They can see, they're omnidirectional.
Yep.
And sorry to interrupt, but that also has something to do with, it's this idea of seeing, you know, the full picture.
Yeah, no, I've definitely thought about that before.
Yeah.
And I was thinking, if a crab with its sideways thinking was to make music, it would be seeing.
Right.
With its ears.
It's amazing. You know what I mean? It's mind-blowing, right?
It's revolutionary, yeah. Really. And so this first piece of music that we're going to be playing, although I do, you know, still experience a bit of shame, but it's important for a Zephyr male to be open.
It's important for us to be vulnerable. We're going to talk a bit later about the soft underbelly, and it's.
So I am in a sense exposing my soft underbelly, but hopefully for the purpose that it's instructive, and that there's something that you and hopefully you will get out of this.
Right.
So this first piece of music indicates just horizontal, rigid, hard thinking.
Yeah, it's going to be difficult to listen to, but it's okay. It's okay to feel vulnerable when you listen to this.
And I do strongly advise students, adherents, to breathe through these difficult experiences.
Yeah.
So if you need to breathe,
should we actually do a breathing exercise right now?
I would love that.
Great.
Do you have any that you prefer?
Yeah. Yeah, so a simple breathing exercise you can do is take your empty cloverleaf clam juice bottle and just breathe in. And as you breathe out, breathe into the bottle and it will evoke the sound of the sea.
Mm.
Just do one more, one more, one more.
Feels great.
I feel calmer.
Yeah.
So you're going to play the first track.
Yeah.
And what's do you want to say the name of it, or are you too ashamed?
I think it's best that we just let the listener.
Okay. All right.
Here.
All right then.
Tim, do you mind playing track one?
Is it okay? If...
Please, please. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's. I mean, no disrespect, but that's pretty awful.
I am ashamed. I am ashamed. But it's part of the process that we all have to go through.
I can't listen to anymore.
It kind of makes me feel sick. I'm sorry. Yeah,
Tim, can you cut it, please?
Yeah.
Just turn it off. Thanks.
Okay.
So, but the crazy thing is disgusting as that was, there's like a nugget in there that you took, right? A tiny piece.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
You then went on to do something completely different and completely amazing that I think shows this kind of proto Zephyr vibe that you can feel coming through.
I think the transformation is extraordinary.
Yeah.
I felt entirely refreshed, rejuvenated. I felt that, in a sense, I had shed and regrown an exoskeleton of sorts, which is to say, how I present...
A hard outer shell.
My hard outer shell
to
the world.
Right.
So maybe we can... Do you want to take a listen?
Yeah, let's take a listen.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So, Tim, do you mind lining up the second track?
So nice.
It's so different, right?
Yeah. Good effects too.
Yep. Can you hear how the echoes?
Yeah. Sight out. Echoes out.
It echoes out.
It's just like Zephyr consciousness, really.
That's right.
Yeah. It's... And this is, to me, this is when I really started to get into your stuff, you know, was this is one of the defining tracks for me that Scorpion Rider has made.
Yeah. No, a lot of men out there have really connected with this one.
Mm.
And it makes sense to me. You know, I have over a million followers on Spotify now, all who are getting great benefits. I've been curated in galleries all around the world because people need to hear this.
Yeah.
It's quite important, actually.
Wow. You know, there's something just really innocent and timeless about that track. And it makes me realize that it encapsulates another aspect of the Zephyr Male, which is neoteny.
Mm.
And... for those of you that aren't familiar with that word, the best organism to look at would be the axolotl, which is neotenous. It's kind of permanently in this juvenile state, and yet it's very advanced and I would say evolved. Like, they can lose a limb and grow it back. They can even lose a part of their brain and grow it back, which I know I've done that before. It was difficult. It was painful, but that's part of growth.
Mm-hmm.
What I love about that track is it has that feel to it.
Mm-hmm. I definitely feel like I lost a limb and I regrew stronger and I would say longer limb.
Yeah.
The thing to note about the axolotl too is that we're going to be talking about this a bit more in a couple of moments, but the axolotl is entirely soft underbelly.
It is.
You think of most creatures, you think of the deer, right? You think of the rabbit.
Sometimes, yeah.
Yeah. You think of the snake.
Mm-hmm.
What do they all have in common?
Soft underbelly?
Soft underbelly. Now, the axolotl is entirely soft
underbelly. It's all over. It's the top and the bottom and the sides.
Yeah. Which is very important, actually, to exemplify these certain characters.
Yeah, it's so vulnerable that it, I would argue, it becomes super strong as a result.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. That's right.
And that's what you did with that first track. It was so bad, and yet you were able to let it go and move on to the next thing.
Yeah, like a limb.